Never miss another fabulous cultural event in Cotacachi just because you can't speak Spanish. In other words, tells you everything you need to know about life in Cotacachi. And here is our host, Deborah May.
Welcome to In Other Words, the only English language program on public radio in Cotacachi. You may be wondering, why are you listening to an English language radio program here in the northern Andes of Ecuador? So, let me share with you the mission of In Other Words. Our goal is to facilitate the social and cultural integration of English-speaking foreign residents with native Spanish-speaking and Kichwa-speaking residents by providing multicultural information and lessons in the primary languages of Cotacachi, Kichwa and Castellano. Every Friday afternoon at 4, you will find out what special events are going on next week in the Cotacachi area. Now, this month and in May, there will be many special celebrations in the indigenous communities of Cotacachi, so be sure to listen closely to our announcements about what's going on. I'm your host, Deborah May. Today, Katia Estrella is going to teach us more words in Spanish, and Apak Perugachi is going to teach us a little about the Kichwa language itself. And later, I'm going to be interviewing officers and veterinarians from the Amici, Cannis Foundation. That includes Jaime Mino, Jim Mackay, Heather Stein, and Marcela Pineda. You probably already have heard that Amici, Cannis is having a big second anniversary party tomorrow, so we're really fortunate to have them with us today. In other words, stay tuned and enjoy the show.
Find out about the local events in Cotacachi before they happen on What's Going On. What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? What's going on?
Okay, so what's going on this week in Cotacachi of interest to our English language listeners? If you're interested in learning something about horse therapy, the city of Cotacachi is sponsoring a presentation tomorrow morning at 10 about the benefits of hipoterapia. The presentation will be held at Centro Sol de Vida. That's located next to the Francisco Espinosa Stadium, not far from the large red metal sculpture of the sun at Plaza del Sol. So I looked up horse therapy online last night. I found out it involves treatments that involve activities and interactions between people and horses to promote human physical and mental health. Hipoterapia, who knew? So that's tomorrow at 10 o'clock in the morning at Centro Sol de Vida. Also tomorrow, Amici Cannis is holding their second anniversary party on Saturday, April 21, from 2 to 4 p.m. The Amici Cannis Animal Hospital is located near the Cotacachi Fire Department just off Tarqui. Guests are invited to come, get a tour of the hospital, meet the vets and other staff, and visit the dogs in their adoption program. Refreshments and goodies will be served as well. And stay tuned to this program because in just a few minutes, I will be interviewing the veterinarians and officers from that organization, Amici Cannis Animal Hospital, right here on In Other Words. At the same time that Amici Cannis will be having its anniversary party, Steve Donoso will be showing a beautiful Japanese film with English subtitles at the Ami Cine Teatro, located at the Ami Fundación in Cotacachi. In this film called Afterlife, people who have just died find themselves at a way station somewhere between heaven and earth, and each soul is given 3 days to choose a single cherished memory from their life that they will relive for eternity. It sounds like a really wonderful movie. It starts at 2, and your $5 donation supports the work of Ami Fundación. Omazni invites you to join them for a dance party with live music, food, and mural creation. And that event is going on around 5. It's being hosted in Ibarra. Omazni is a group that focuses on the conservation of biodiversity through respect for life and the cultural practices that communities propose for alternative development. You can find more details on their Facebook page, Omazni, O-M-A-S-N-E. E, omasne. Okay. So then, let's see, April 28th, not this Saturday, but next Saturday, the community of La Calera is inviting everyone to join them for special events and ceremonies. That begins early in the afternoon and goes into the evening. So you can come around 1 to catch the speeches, ribbon cutting, and soccer games, or you can come closer to 6 in the evening to enjoy a cultural program with music and dance, including the local band Los Mayas. It's all free. The indigenous community of Santa Barbara is having a fair featuring traditional Kichwa foods and crafts on May 5th. That's May 5, from noon until 10 at night at their Casa Comunal. All are welcome to attend their Feria de Comidas Ancestrales y Artesanías. The community of Morochos invites everyone, that means you too, to attend their 80th anniversary celebration on Saturday, May 12th. So that's a few weeks from now. That starts at 6 o'clock. It will feature music, dance, and of course, a beauty contest in the Kichwa tradition. The event is free of charge. Being scheduled for 6, remember it probably will begin closer to 7 in the evening. Morochos is another of the 45 indigenous communities surrounding Cotacachi. And if you love watching dance groups perform, remember there will be a huge dance competition for local dance troops called Alpa Mama Tushui 2018, or in English, Mother Earth Dance 2018. Those competitions will be held in San Juan de Iluman on April 29th and again on May 13th, starting at 10 in the morning. More details about upcoming events that are not already being promoted in English language social media often can be found on the Another Words Facebook group page. So join the group and learn more about what's going on in Cotacachi.
Every Friday afternoon at 4 p.m., English Language Radio in Cotacachi.
A word from one of our sponsors, you will feel right at home at La Quadra Hostal and Cafe. Enjoy their relaxed and comfortable family atmosphere. The hotel is located in the center of Cotacachi, Modesto Penherrera, just a half block from Atriz Park. To make reservations, call 06-291-6015.
And now it's time to learn a few words in Kichwa. Mama Urku and Apak Perugachi speak Kichwapi.
Welcome to Kichwapi, where English speakers get a chance to learn about the language of the indigenous people who live in the Andes and here in Cotacachi. Apak Perugachi is a certified professional Kichwa language instructor who currently teaches Kichwa to Spanish speakers here in Cotacachi. He also is co-author of a book, now being translated into English, about why and how the four major Kichwa holidays, including Inti Raymi, are celebrated here in Cotacachi. In today's lesson, Apak will answer some questions about the Kichwa language itself, and I will translate its answers into English. Welcome to the studio, Apak.
Yupaychani, Tukuisha, Alipunja, Charipachinchi, muchas gracias. Que tengan todos nuestros radios escuchas. Buenos días.
Well, thank you very much for being here. So let's get right into the interview. Apak, about how many people speak Kichwa?
Los Kichwas hablantes, hay que diferenciar muy bien el Quechua Kichwa. Entonces, hay aproximadamente el Quechua y el Kichwa, la unión, 10 millones aproximadamente. Estos Quechuas hablantes están ubicados en varios países.
So Apak says that, first of all, it's very important to make a distinction between Kichwa and Quechua. In total, all the Kichwa and Quechua speakers would be about 10 million. Quechua speakers are found in different countries, not only in Ecuador, but Kichwa is more a thing of Ecuador itself. Where do people speak Kichwa, Apak?
La lengua Quechua es la madre, digamos. El Kichwa es una variedad. Entonces, ¿dónde está la gente que habla Kichwa? Kichwa, especialmente Kichwa, solo en Ecuador. Pero Quechua tenemos en Perú, Bolivia, una parte de Chile, Argentina y Ecuador. Ecuador es la variedad Kichwa.
All right. APAC says that, first of all, Kichwa should be considered the mother language from which Kichwa is derived. So Kichwa is actually the first one. And from that comes Kichwa, like a variation or a dialect of that. Kichwa is, as he said before, spoken in different languages like Bolivia and Peru and Argentina and Chile, but also obviously in Ecuador. Whereas Kichwa, that variant, is only found in Ecuador. Bueno, APAC, what is the difference between Kichwa and Quechua exactly?
La diferencia más sería, como es un dialecto, el aparato fonético. Entonces, digamos, un ejemplo, en el Cusco es la glotal, ¿sí? Como decir Cusco o ñoca. Y acá decimos Cusco, ñuca, ¿sí? Entonces, y también, más es la fonética, el dialecto es, digamos, la diferencia.
All right, there are some phonetic differences. And those differences can be found, for example, in a word like Cusco, where in Ecuador, people would actually pronounce these words quite easily, like Cusco. Whereas in Peru, this word would come out much more like Cusco, a much more glottal sound to it. So those are the slight differences between Kichwa and Quechua. Since most indigenous people in the Andes speak Spanish today, why is it important to learn and speak a language that most people in Ecuador don't even understand?
Bueno, para esta pregunta, nosotros entendemos a las lenguas como algo vivo. Por eso decimos la ecología lingüística. En la ecología, viendo, digamos, en las especies, puede ser algunas en peligro de extinción, otras. Entonces, es lo mismo con las lenguas, ¿sí? Entonces, hay muchas lenguas en todo el mundo, esta variedad, digamos, de lenguas, también hay una variedad de pensamientos en el mundo. Entonces, pero si una lengua muere, hay una variedad menos.
He just said that we should actually think of languages not as just things that we use to communicate, but much rather as living things. A language is kind of like a living organism. It reproduces and it changes over time. And apart from that, as APAC explains, every language represents a way of thinking. And that is a very important thing to consider. Because as languages live and also die, they get extinct, we kind of lose a certain perspective on reality. APAC takes a very biological approach to languages and appreciates the importance of the existence of certain languages because they represent this way of thinking. So losing a language like Kichwa, for example, would be losing perspective on reality and really a way of thinking.
Entonces, para nosotros es importante mantener esto, porque la lengua es la máxima expresión de una cultura o es la puerta hacia una cultura. Entonces, el Kichwa durante estos tiempos ha tenido una resistencia y es muy importante que viva esta lengua. En la lengua está la filosofía, el pensamiento de una cultura.
It's really important to see the cultural and the cultural aspect, and also really the perspective that any language may take toward reality. Every language has its own methods and techniques to analyze reality and represent that using words. It's really a great loss, cultural loss. A language embodies, as it were, the cultural heritage of a people also, and that is all concentrated in that language. So losing that would be very, very sad.
So that was the first half of a two-part lesson on the Kichwa language, spoken by so many of our Ecuadorian neighbors here in Cotacachi. Next week, APAC will tell us more about how we all benefit by preserving this and other indigenous languages. Now, here's a song I'm sure you all will remember from 1971 by the band who called themselves simply America.
On the first part of the journey, I was looking at all the life. There were plants and birds and rocks and things. There was sand and hills and rain. The first thing I met was a fly with a buzz and the sky with no clouds. The heat was hot and the ground was dry, but the air was full of sound. I've been through the desert on a horse with no name. It felt good to be out of the rain.
desert, you can't remember your name, 'cause there ain't no one for to give you no pain. La 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 la. After 2 days in the desert sun, my skin began to turn red. After 3 days in the desert fun, I was looking at a riverbed, and the story it told of a river that flowed made me sad to think it was dead. You see, I've been through the desert on a horse with no name. It felt good to be out of the rain. In the desert, you can't remember your name, 'cause there ain't no one for to give you no pain. La 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 la. Had turned to sea. There were plants and birds and rocks and things. There were sand and hills and rings. The ocean is a desert with its life underground and the perfect disguise above. Under the cities lies a heart made of ground, but the humans will give no love. See, I've been through the desert on a horse with no name. It felt good to be out of the rain. In the desert, you can't remember your name, 'cause there ain't no one for to give you no pain. La 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 la.
Check out our program page for In Other Words on Radio Pública Cotacachi.
On May 4th, Yannick Pak, the ever popular Yannick, will be joining us, and he'll be talking about Pandela, and he's one of our sponsors, so this is what he wants to tell you. He says Pandela has things that are bread and other things that are delicious, whole grain, healthy, sourdough, natural, selected, creative, seeded, tasty, handmade breads. Find Pandela Cotacachi on Facebook or call them at 099-3682-314. Pandela, because life is better while eating.
Get to know your neighbors with total Spanish immersion. Vamos.
Okay, so we have again in the studio Katy Estrella, which means star, from the Pucara Spanish School, located right here in Cotacachi near San Francisco Square. And Katy is going to be teaching Spanish words today to our English-speaking audience. And we're going to talk today about how to ask someone their name and how they're doing. How are you?
Bien, gracias, Débora. Bueno, vamos a empezar con una pregunta muy importante. ¿Cómo se llama? Es la manera formal de preguntar. ¿Cómo se llama? What is your name?
Okay, so we're going to begin with ¿cómo se llama?, which is the formal way of saying what is your name.
Exacto. Y la forma informal, ¿cómo te llamas?, si es un amigo o una persona muy conocida.
Okay, so if it's someone you know, or it's someone that's your age or a younger person, you might go for the more informal, ¿cómo te llamas?
Exacto.
Can you repeat those two phrases for us again?
Entonces, tenemos dos preguntas. Formal, ¿cómo se llama? Informal, ¿cómo te llamas?
Okay, very good. And that basically just means, what is your name?
Exacto. La respuesta es, yo me llamo Katy. Yo me llamo Katy Estrella, formalmente.
So, And my name is Deborah, would be me llamo Deborah. Exactly. Me llamo Deborah, which literally means I am called Deborah.
Exacto.
And
exacto.
Cómo se llama is how are you called? What are you called?
Mm-hmm. Right. Entonces, cuando nos preguntan cómo se llama usted, decimos me llamo Katy Estrella, con el apellido.
Okay. So, ¿cómo se llama?
Me llamo Katy Estrella. ¿Cómo te llamas?
Me llamo Deborah.
Excelente, Deborah. Ahora voy a explicar también cómo preguntar how are you. ¿Cómo estás?
How are you would be ¿cómo estás?
Es informal.
Informal. Again, uh-huh. With a friend or a younger person. So you would not use that in a formal situation or with a senior person or your teacher. You probably wouldn't come in and say, hey, ¿cómo estás?
Uh-huh. Right. Uh-huh. Bueno, depende de la relación que tengan con la persona. Pero normalmente personas que no conocemos muy bien, decimos, ¿cómo está?
Okay, so with people that we don't know very well, or to demonstrate a great deal of respect with someone, we would say, ¿cómo está? Mm-hmm. ¿Cómo está?
Exacto. Uh-huh. Y informalmente, ¿cómo estás?
And with someone where we're in a more informal situation, we know the person, we would say, ¿cómo estás? So how do we respond to that question? How are you?
Exacto. Vamos a responder a estas preguntas como, ¿estoy bien? ¿Estoy mal? Estoy así, así. Estoy más o menos.
Okay, so the first phrase that you said was, estoy bien. What does that mean?
Es como, I am well.
Okay, I'm good. I'm fine. I'm well. Estoy bien. Can you say that a few more times for our audience?
Sí, te repito, Deborah. Entonces, la respuesta es, estoy bien. Estoy bien. Estoy bien. Gracias.
Okay, so, ¿cómo está?
Estoy bien, gracias. ¿Y usted?
Ah, estoy bien, gracias. Okay, so I'm fine, thank you. And if you're not doing that well, what would you say to someone who asks you how you are?
Bueno, depende si quieres contar a todos cómo estás. Entonces, estoy mal.
Estoy mal. I'm not doing so well. Estoy mal.
Mm-hmm. Repito, estoy mal. Mm-hmm. Y si quieres decir estoy así, así, significa...
Ah, so-so, so-so. Uh-huh. Not doing that great, así, así. But we would say, estoy así, así. Mm. ¿Es correcto?
Sí, es correcto. Mm-hmm. O puedes decir en Ecuador, estoy bien, o estoy más o menos.
Más o menos. So more or less. I am more or less, literally. But what we'd be saying is, estoy más o menos. So we have different ways of responding to the question, ¿cómo está? Formal, or ¿cómo estás? Informal. We can say, I'm good.
Estoy bien.
I'm not so good.
Estoy mal.
And, so-so.
Estoy más o menos, o estoy así, así.
Okay.
Otra cosa que te quería decir es, muchas personas dicen, ¿cómo estás? Pero es un saludo.
Ah, so sometimes people just say, how are you, as a way of saying hello.
Ajá, exacto.
Ajá. So
hola, ¿cómo estás?
Hola. And hola means...
Hello. Sí. Y no okay. Es necesario una respuesta de decir estoy bien o estoy mal. Simplemente es un saludo.
Okay, so I could just say, hola, ¿cómo está? And you would say?
Estoy bien, gracias. ¿Y usted?
Ah, así, así. No, I'm doing great because we're having a really good Spanish lesson here with Katy Estrella from the Pucara Spanish School. Katy, thank you so much for coming in this week and teaching us these wonderful things, and we will see you again next week.
Hasta pronto. Chao.
Okay, so Katy Estrella is an experienced Spanish teacher with over 20 years of teaching experience in Europe and Ecuador. Remember, you can find links to all of our teachers, interview guests, and sponsors on our Facebook group page. In other words, one of those sponsors is Prana Vital Energy, offering local organic produce, nuts, oils, wine, books, and much more. Located on the corner of 9 de Octubre and Roca Fuerte, Prana invites you to browse their shop on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays. So coming right up after some messages from our sponsors, we're going to be talking with the folks from Amici Cannis. Look forward to seeing you in a few minutes.
You are listening to In Other Words. Listen to the special people who define Cotacachi here in Something to Talk About.
a very warm welcome today to Doctora Marcela Pineda, a beloved local veterinarian and the director of Amici Cannis Animal Hospital here in Cotacachi. With her today are Amici Cannis Foundation President Jim Mackay, Vice President Heather Stain. And thank you just so much for coming here to Radio Pública Cotacachi today to tell my listeners more about the history of your organization and the services you provide today. And I want to start by saying that Amici Cannis always has taken excellent care of my own little dog, Bodie, since I first came here to Cotacachi a few years ago. And almost exactly 1 year ago, a committed volunteer from Amici Cannis drove 3 miles up a mountain to a poor indigenous community where I lived at the time. I saw him put 6 neighborhood dogs into crates piled up in the back of his van. He drove the dogs to the clinic in Cotacachi, where a sizable brigade of volunteer veterinarians from the U.S. spayed all the dogs, along with dozens of others, at no cost in 1 day. The volunteers then drove all the dogs back up the mountain to their very grateful indigenous owners, who definitely do not want more puppies but simply can't afford the cost of spaying or neutering their dogs. And then just a month ago, I brought a dog into your clinic, a very sick, starving puppy we had rescued from inside a tied plastic bag someone dropped in a water canal to drown him. But Doctora Pineda gave him immediate emergency care when he needed it. I'm happy to say our little Hambatu survived his ordeal. So I've seen for myself how Amici Cannis has served the community and grown dramatically in just a few years. I have tremendous admiration for your organization, volunteers, and staff. And I know many of my listeners are as curious as I am about when and how Amici Cannis first got started. So what was happening at the time with the dog population that motivated some individuals who lived here in Cotacachi to create this new response to old problems?
It was about 7 years ago, Deb. We had a fellow come in from the U.S., from California, and he was a great animal lover. And he first noticed, of course, it didn't take too much to see the tremendous proliferation of dogs on the street that nobody seemed to want or care for. And he, being a good animal lover, got a couple of friends together, tried to raise money, which was a bit of a challenge. We used to sell dog cookies on the street and a little table on Leather Street for $1.75.
Wow.
And a couple of times a year we do some fundraisers or bake sales. But it was a slow process.
Mm-hmm.
And, it was a struggle. We had board members who were committed to it and dedicated to it, and a group of volunteers that came and went. And that's how it started.
Wow. Okay. So, Doctora Pineda, what did the animal hospital look like when you first started your work here? What did it look like?
Well, actually, at the beginning, the idea was just do surgeries during 3 days, and we was thinking like to rent a small room to do a surgery room in that room, but everything changed. Then we realized that we can do something better for the puppies.
Uh-huh.
So at the beginning, we start like with the basic things that we moved since United States, when I went to United States to be trained by Dr. Stain. We moved like 2 bags of things, and that was the beginning of the clinic with 2 bags of things.
Wow, so very very humble beginnings here.
Yeah, we started out just trying to make a small impact with small groups of dogs that we were spaying and neutering, and we realized we needed to do so much more. So in 2015, we became an official 501c3 in the United States, and we started doing major fundraising, grant proposals. We got a tremendous number of donations from organizations in the United States, as well as fellow veterinarians, that helped us equip our clinic. So we opened the Amici Cannis actual hospital here in Cotacachi in April of 2016, and we have been able to equip it to be a full-service veterinary hospital now.
So so you do much more than neutering and spaying animals. When you say full service, could you describe some of those services?
Absolutely. And I think it's important for people to understand there's multiple levels to Amici Cannis. There's the Amici Cannis Foundation, which is actually an officially nonprofit here in Ecuador. There's also the United States leg of Amici Cannis that is the umbrella organization that we fundraise for the local organization. So anybody who's interested in donating to Amici Cannis can actually donate in the United States and have a tax deduction legally in the United States. But the foundation here is the overseer of the clinic. And our clinic is divided into multiple sections. We cover the care of all of the street dogs in Cotacachi. We actually are responsible for taking those dogs, spaying and neutering them, vaccinating them, deworming them, feeding them, providing them food. If one of our dogs on the streets is seen to be ill, anybody can call the clinic and we'll go and pick them up and take care of them. We have taken in those street dogs as our own pets and we treat them as community dogs now. That's why the dogs in Cotacachi look so much better. The other leg of our clinic is that we actually are a full-service veterinary hospital that can provide wellness services, surgeries, soft tissue, as well as orthopedic surgeries, digital x-ray, ultrasound, in-house laboratory services, full service veterinary care within the clinic for people who own animals. And the goal of our foundation, running as a nonprofit, is that by providing these services and charging reasonable fees for them, we actually are raising money to take care of the street dogs. So every time somebody brings one of their pets to our clinic, they need to realize they're not only getting great care for their beloved animal, but they're actually donating money to help the street dogs in Cotacachi.
Wow. So you have grown so much in such a short amount of time. I'm just very impressed. How many people do you have on staff at this time?
Well, yes, because at the beginning we start just with one doctor. I'm full-time, that was mine, and one technician. Currently, we have two doctors full-time, four technicians, and we have four doctors volunteers. So it's almost 12. I can count just in Spanish.
So I understand that your situation, your need for volunteers has changed a great deal. I did a little volunteering back when you first opened, and that was taking care of dogs who were recovering from surgery. But I understand that today your need for volunteers is very different.
Yes, it's true, because at the beginning we just was having like the spay and neuter clinics, so we was needing volunteers to wash the instruments and to take care of the dogs at their recovery. Now we have a staff that can do that, and we have clinics all the time, so we cannot have volunteers all the time. But we have our small adoption program and our small our street dogs that comes all days to take the breakfast or dinner or lunch, they choose. And we need help with that. I mean, to check when they are here, to walk the dogs, to take care, to help us to clean the dogs that are in the adoption program. Things like that are more things like cleaning, walk the dogs. They are not like the big responsibilities that we used to do give at the beginning to the volunteers.
Mm-hmm.
It's so much less.
Okay, and I'm sure you have volunteers involved in fundraising events?
We do. We actually are working very hard to be self-sustainable with the programs that we have developed. Our model originally was to become self-sustainable, so we were not dependent on donations. So what we really appreciate is to keep us moving is donations of food for the dogs that we take care of on the streets and the dogs that we keep in our adoption program. And then if people bring dogs in that are in need of care, if they can donate towards the care of those dogs, that helps us a great deal.
So you actually would welcome someone walking in with a large bag of dog food just to donate to
any day of the week.
Definitely.
That's always a good thing. And I know there's a local store that does a discount on certain days for dog
yes.
Food.
What is
Monica's?
Yes, at Monica's.
We're so grateful for her help.
Yes, yeah, the supermercado, and she helps us always. So you can go there, buy the food, leave it there, and we will go to pick up.
Ah, so you. The person who buys the food doesn't have to deliver it. Monica actually will make sure it's picked up.
She put the name of the person that donated. If the people don't want to put the name, don't have to. But she put the name, and then we pick up the food.
We're very, very lucky. We have a couple of amazing volunteers that have been part of our organization from the beginning. Mm-hmm. Brian and Jeanette Sullivan, they're invaluable. We wouldn't be able to do what we do without them. Jeanette plays a role in coordinating events for us, local fundraising, volunteers. She pretty much fills every hat. If anybody who knows Jeanette knows that that's who she is. Mm-hmm. Brian is our official animal security officer. So he actually goes and picks up sick animals for us and will help us move dogs around. So mm-hmm. if we see a female that's in heat that's being attacked by other dogs, Brian will do his best to go and retrieve that dog so we can get her spayed, mm-hmm. prevent puppies from being born, help injured animals. So without them, we wouldn't be able to do the work we do.
Right. So you have dogs that are available for adoption now?
Oh, yes, definitely. We have cats, three amazing cats.
Of course they're amazing.
Yes. That are ready for adoption. And we have like seven puppies that are ready for adoption. All kinds of mix of breeds and all kinds of size. So you just have to come and look the dogs. And we have the whole green collars. The green collars that we have in the street that are already spayed, have all the shots, are dewormed. So if someone is looking for a dog, have these three options. Adopt a cat, adopt one puppy of our program, or adopt a green collar of the street.
Okay, so we're talking with the veterinarians from Amici Cannis, Dr. Heather Stain, Dr. Marcela Pineda, and the president of Amici Cannis,
Jim.
Okay, so we'll be right back in just a moment.
The party was nice, the party was bumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started name calling. And the girls respond to the call. I have a poor one shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Get back, Ruffy, Bas Ruffy, get back, you flee, invest in mongrel. Gonna tell myself I man, no get angry.
Hey, yeah.
Two Eddie cows calling them canine. Hey!
Okay, so we're back now with the folks from Amici Cannis, and I know something listeners want to know is how can I make an appointment for my animal with you at the clinic?
Well, we've recently started on Facebook. We have an online appointment tool on Facebook, so you can always just go onto Facebook and request an appointment. We also have standard hours, which are from 8 to 5, Monday through Friday, and 8 to 3 on Saturdays. So you can actually just come down during that period of time. If you have anything urgent, it's better just to come in. If you're looking to schedule a regular wellness appointment, or it's something that can wait, feel free to do it on Facebook through the scheduling tool.
Okay, so Dr. Stain, you're saying that drop-ins at the clinic are welcome.
They are. We have enough staff and enough doctors now that we receive drop-ins.
Wow, that is just such good news. That's amazing. Can you tell us approximately how many dogs you've neutered or spayed over the last few years or recently?
Well, we start 2 years ago. On the first year, we did 588 spays and neuters. On the next year, 632. And so far of 2018, 200 dogs. So it's a total of 1,000 dogs, more than 1,000 dogs that we already spay and neuters.
So in just the time you've been operating, you have...
Exactly.
Wow.
In the 2 years.
1,000. That's excellent work. Excellent work.
Deborah, you have to know that it's not all an uphill battle because we struggle. And here's why. One unneutered male dog in Cotacachi can impregnate five females in a month. That's an average of 40 puppies from that one male alone, which is over 400 puppies by that one male dog alone in a year.
Mm-hmm.
And when you walk down the streets and look at the number of unneutered male dogs there are, you can do the math.
Mm-hmm.
So as good as strong as our effort has been, we are constantly looking for new opportunities because they just multiply.
Okay, and I know that locally folks are more likely to bring in a female for a spay than a male for a neuter. So, Jim, those are some really interesting statistics that we can share with folks for sure.
Absolutely. I mean, if you look at Humane Society International's statistics, they focus on spay first because that's the harder thing to do, and that helps eliminate the carrier for the puppies. Mm-hmm. But we really do need to be neutering the dogs as well. Mm-hmm. So changing the mentality and helping people understand that we have to neuter the males as well as spay the females is important. We are doing some census work right now, which was requested of us by Dogs Trust International, that is allowing us to track our statistics on how much we're accomplishing. So we started the census at the end of 2017, and that will be repeated every 6 months. So we'll be able to provide statistics on what we're actually accomplishing.
Okay, wow. And I'm just so impressed. You have an open house coming up tomorrow, a special celebration of your second anniversary. Can you tell us more about that?
Exactly. Tomorrow, Saturday, since 2 p.m. to 4 p.m., you can come, you can see our dogs in adoption, meet all the doctors that works at the Amici Cannis, do a tour around all the clinic, and you will receive a coupon of 10% of discount in all our services.
Okay, and everyone is welcome?
Everybody's welcome. We are at the street No Name and Pasaje Tarqui, near of the fire station.
Okay, and people can ask where the Amici Cannis veterinarians are, and they'll probably get directions.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, great. Anything else anyone would like to add in the last few minutes we have here?
We appreciate you having us on the radio and highlighting what we do.
Well, the community so appreciates you and the work that you do. I can't tell you how many people came up to me and said, I am listening today because I want to hear from the folks at Amici Cannis. They're doing such a great job.
We also want to thank the Municipio because they have really embraced our clinic and partnered with us. We have a tremendous collaboration with the Municipio in Cotacachi. We're very proud of our relationship with the Municipio. They have helped us and enable us to accomplish what we have.
All good news. All right, then. Well, thank you again for taking time out of your busy day before your big event to talk with our listeners. We have Jim Mackay, Dr. Heather Stain, and Doctora Marcela Pineda. And I hope you'll join them tomorrow at their clinic for the celebration of the second anniversary of the founding of the Amici Cannis Animal Hospital. So, thank you. Woof Puppy is one of our sponsors. Did you know that Woof Puppy Dog Grooming and Pet Shop of Cotacachi gently bathes and grooms your dog so he looks great and feels great too? And at Woof Puppy, you'll find high quality pet food and accessories for every kind of pet. So visit them at the corner of Pedro Mancayo near Matriz Park and check out their Facebook page, Woof Puppy. That's W-O-O-F, Woof Puppy. Thanks for listening this week to another episode of In Other Words. We'll be back next Friday and every Friday afternoon at 4 with more language lessons, classic oldies that are going to bring back some great memories from our youth. And next week, In Other Words, we'll give listeners something to talk about when I interview local yoga teacher Cheryl Kane, who will share with us the benefits of practicing yoga and her own personal journey as a yoga student and teacher for many years. And then, in May, I have a great lineup of interview guests, including the founder of Uno a Uno, a local bread maker from Germany, the president of Cotacachi's largest indigenous community, and the man who coordinates the thrilling Paseo de Chagras, a time when hundreds of horses and riders, looking their best, will dance for us in local parades. Remember, every program, we start with announcements of upcoming public events in Cotacachi, things that are not so easy to find out about because the print publicity is in Kichwa or Spanish. I interpret these announcements for you to the best of my ability so that you won't miss these spectacular cultural events in Cotacachi. If you want to get in touch with any of our language teachers, guests, or sponsors from In Other Words, please go to In Other Words program page on the Radio Pública Cotacachi website. Or
you can join our Facebook group of the same name to share your thoughts about what you heard today. Thank you for joining me for another episode of In Other Words. We'll talk to you again next Friday at 4. Hasta viernes. Chaska punja kaman. Thank you. Gracias. Yupaychani mashikuna.
Who let the dogs out?
Who let the dogs out?
Hoot, 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 hoot.
Who let the dogs out?
The party was nice, the party was pumping.
Hey, yeah.
V-I-O.
And everybody having a ball.
V-I-O.
Until the fellas started name calling.
V-I-O.
And the girls respond to the call. I have a pull my shout out.
Who let the dogs out?
Who
let the dogs out?
Who
let the dogs out?
Who
let the dogs out?
Get back, Gruffy, Bash Gruffy, get back, you flea infested mongrel. Gonna tell myself I'm man, no get angry.
Hey, yeah.
V-I-O.
Two Eddie girls calling them canine. Hey,
V-I-O.
But they tell me, hey man, start up the party.
V-I-O.
You put a woman in front and a man behind. I heard a woman shout out.
Who let the dogs out?
Who
let the dogs out?
Who
let the dogs out?
Who
let the dogs out?
Say, a doggy is nothing if he don't have a bone.
A doggy, hold your bone. A doggy, hold it.
A doggy is nothing if he don't have a bone.
A doggy, hold your bone.
Who let the dogs out?
Who
let the dogs out?
Who
let the dogs out?
I see the young people had a ball, cause you believe on this get out. Get back, Gruffy, Bash Gruffy, get back, you flea infested mongrel.
Well, if I am a dog, the party is on. I gotta get my groove on, cause my mind I'm gone. Do you see the rays coming from my eye? Walking through the place, the Digimon is breaking them down. Me and my white socks, short, dill, and gancy color. Any caliber do, I think I knew that's why they call me Pitbull. Cause I'm the man of the land, when they see me, they say, ooh.
Who let the dogs out?
Thank you for listening to our program. In other words, we'll see you again next Friday at the same time, 4 p.m. on Radio Pública Cotacachi.
Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, ooh, please be true. In other words.